is new chapter, Applications of Vector Algebra. In 11th standard, you have studied about vectors, isn't it? What we have learned in 11th standard, we have learned how to find out the addition of two vectors, subtraction of two vectors, and what about the types of vectors, everything we have learned in the 11th standard. And also we have learned the product of two vectors using scalar product as well as the cross product, isn't it? So we have learned everything in 11th standard. Just now I am going to give the definition of dot product and cross product for you to remember, okay? So first, let A vector is equal to A1 I vector plus A2 J vector, it is cap. A1 I cap, A2 J cap plus A3 K cap. And B vector can be taken as B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. So, can you recall how to write down the dot product of two vectors? Dot product is nothing but the scalar product, isn't it? So, how to write down the dot product of two vectors? Can you recall this? By definition, how can we write the dot product of two vectors? Dot product gives a scalar quantity because it is a scalar vector, scalar product, okay? So, how to find out I dot I will become as 1. So, the first term will be A1 B1 plus this I dot J will become as 0, I dot K will become as 0. Similarly, J dot I will become as 0, but J dot J is equal to 1. So, A2 B2. Similarly, we can write down A3 B3. Okay. So, dot product of two vectors is A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. Now, let us go with cross product of two vectors. What is A vector cross B vector? It is a vector quantity. So, we have to use determinant I cap, J cap and K cap. The first row will be the first element, that is A1, A2, A3. The second row will be from B components, B1, B2, B3. Okay. So, this is the dot product of two vectors and scalar product, vector product of two vectors. And now we can see some important notes. When A dot B is equal to 0, A dot B is equal to 0 if and only if A vector dot B vector is A vector is perpendicular to B vector. This is first note, isn't it? Second note, when A vector cross B vector is equal to 0, when the cross product will become a 0, when they are parallel. So, just opposite condition, when two vectors are perpendicular, that dot product will be equal to 0. When two vectors are parallel, that cross product will become as 0. So, these two are very important notes we have to recall from the previous class, okay? And then what about the angle between the two vectors? Angle between two vectors can be written using the dot formula. That is cos theta is equal to, isn't it? What is the definition of A vector dot B vector? A vector dot B vector is equal to A vector dot B vector is equal to modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector, cos theta, isn't it? Can you recall this? And then what is A vector cross B vector? What is the definition for A vector cross B vector? Modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector, sin theta, n cap into n cap, where n cap is a perpendicular vector between both A vector and B vector. Now, can you give the angle between two vectors using dot product? Theta is equal to cos inverse of A dot B by modulus of A vector into modulus of B vector, isn't it? So, whenever we need to find out the angle between two vectors, we will use the cross product of two vectors instead of using dot product of two vectors, instead of using cross product of two vectors, because cross product of two vectors will give always the acute angle. So if you want to find out the correct angle between the two vectors, you have to use the dot product of two vectors. So this formula is enough. Theta is equal to cos inverse of A vector dot B vector by modulus of A vector into modulus of B vector. Okay. Now let us go to the applications of vector algebra. So these are all the things we have studied in 11th standard. Here we are going to study about scalar triple product and vector triple product in the next exercise. So in this exercise we are going to see some geometrical applications of vector product. Okay. So the first example, cosine formula. You have already studied what is a cosine formula, what is sine formula, and what is projection formula, isn't it? So now we are going to see application of dot and cross product in trigonometry. So first example is 6.1 cosine formula. We are going to prove cosine formula using vector product. So example 6.1 cosine formula. There are three formulae in cosine, isn't it? You can recall, students, you have studied already this in trigonometry in 11th standard. But here we are going to prove the cosine formula using the vector method. So in any triangle ABC, proof by vector method. So what is the question? Any triangle ABC, what we need to prove? A square is equal to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. Okay, this only we are going to prove. So this is subdivision 1. There are two more subdivisions you can prove by yourself, student. B square is equal to A square plus C square minus 2AC cos B. Similarly, C square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB cos C. Okay, so one subdivision I am going to prove for you, and then you can continue with the other two subdivisions in your notebook. Okay, now for this we need a triangle. So let us draw a triangle first. Okay, let us draw a triangle and extend the sides. So let us draw a triangle. Okay, let us draw a triangle A, B and C. Okay, now let us mark the arrow mark. So it represents a vector, and then now we can write what is the side opposite to the vertex A. It is nothing but A vector. Side opposite to B is B vector, and side opposite to C is C vector. Okay, so we can write now the total angle here will be pi. So what will be this angle? This is pi minus B. Similarly, here the total angle will be pi. So what is this one? Pi minus C. Okay, so here inside it will be C. So what it will be here? This is we can draw like this. Okay, so the diagram will be like this. This is A, pi minus A angle. So let us mark this as A. Okay, so using this, how can you prove this? First, let us start the problem with, let BZ vector is equal to A vector. Let CA vector is equal to B vector. And AB vector is equal to C vector. So using the triangle property, what you know? By the triangle property, we can say that A vector plus B vector plus C vector is equal to 0. Okay. We need this side, the left hand side should be A square. So keep A vector this side and take other two vectors to that side. So I am going to take A vector is equal to minus of B vector plus C vector. Okay. Now squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So by squaring on both sides, what will happen? This will become as A vector square is equal to minus into minus, it will become as plus. Next, B vector plus C vector the whole square. Can you expand using the formula B vector plus C vector the whole square? What's the formula? B vector square plus C vector square plus 2B vector dot C vector into B vector into C vector. What is the thing? We can write it here. B vector dot C vector. So next one we can write B vector square is nothing but B square. Here A vector square is nothing but A square plus this is C square plus 2 into this you can write using the formula of A vector dot B vector. So it is nothing but BC into cos of B and C go and coincide in the place of pi minus A. So cos of pi minus A. B U C U poi seyra edathula namakku enna angle irunduchu pi minus A. So we can write this as this is equal to B square plus C square plus 2BC. What is cos 180 minus theta? Cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta, isn't it? Minus cos A. So we can write this as B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. So we have proved that A square is equal to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. Is it clear, students? So you are going to try with the next two subdivisions. That is B square equal to and C square equal to. So for B square equal to, you have to keep B with this side and take the other two vectors to that side. Similarly for C, you have to keep C this side and take other two vectors to that side. Inga B dot C vandhichina, inga cos pi minus A varano. Inga A dot C vandhichina, cos pi minus B varano. Inga A dot B vandhichina, cos pi minus C varano. Okay, so this is the way to prove the cosine formula using the vector method. Now let us go to the next example, your projection formula. We are going to prove the projection formula now. Example 6.2. It is not named as projection formula in your book, but you can understand that it is a projection formula. In any triangle ABC, prove that in any triangle ABC, the diagrams are very important for geometrical proof of vector method. So we have to draw the diagram. First subdivision we are going to prove A is equal to B cos C plus C cos B. Okay, so this we are going to prove now. Now here again the same diagram we are going to draw with vertices ABC. So, நம்ம எந்த பக்கம் ஆரோ போடுறோமோ அந்த பக்கம் நீ லைனை வந்து எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் பண்ணணும் சரியா சோ இப்படி ஆரோ போட்டோம்னா இந்த லைன் வந்து எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் ஆகும் சோ தட்ஸ் த திங் இது வந்து இப்ப ஏ திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் பி சாரி திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் பி அண்ட் திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் சி ஓகே சோ வாட் இஸ் திஸ் திஸ் இஸ் பை மைனஸ் ஏ அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் திஸ் இஸ் பை மைனஸ் பி அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் ஆங்கிள் திஸ் இஸ் பை மைனஸ் சி ஓகே So and this is A vector and this one is B vector and this one is C vector. Similar to the previous problem, we are starting with this and then we have to go with again we know that. So let us start the problem with AB vector is equal to C vector, BC vector is equal to A vector and CA vector is equal to B vector. Okay. So now we know that A vector plus B vector plus C vector is equal to 0. Okay. So now we need to prove that A is equal to. So keeping A to this side, taking the other two terms to that side, minus B vector minus C vector. In the previous problem, we squared on both sides, isn't it? here we are going to take the dot product of A vector on both sides. So only we can prove the cosine formula. So taking dot product of A vector on both sides. So A vector dot A vector is equal to minus A vector dot B vector minus A vector dot C vector. Is it clear? So what is A vector dot A vector? It is nothing but A vector square, that is A square. Okay. Now minus AB. What's the angle between A and B? It is nothing but cos of pi minus C. Okay. Next minus AC. I am writing with the help of the definition. A vector dot C vector is equal to modulus of A vector modulus of C vector. So it is nothing but AC cos of, what is the angle between A dot C? AU CU and the same radhathla enna angle irukku? Pi minus B. Okay. So this is equal to minus AB into cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta minus AC into cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta. Okay. So let us go to this. Minus into minus, it will become as plus AB cos C plus AC cos B. Okay. Now you can write a divide by A. So that implies dividing by A, we will get A is equal to B cos C plus C cos B. Hence we proved the projection formula. Students, here also I have proved the first formula. You can try with the next two formula in your notebook. If you want to prove that B is equal to, keep B on this side and take the dot product of B on both sides. If you want to prove C is equal to, take C to the left hand side and take the other two term to that side and take the dot product of C vector. Okay, so this is the way to prove the projection formula. Next we are going to prove sine formula. So we have completed with cosine formula, projection formula. The third one is we are going to prove the sine formula. So sine formula, it is example 6.4. After completing with a sine formula, sine nale enga poirum dot product illa cross product. Cos nu varrappa mattum dhaan unakku enna product la nama use pananum, scalar product la use pananum. Ena dot product oda formula enadhu, A dot B is equal to AB cos theta. So namakku enga illa vandu cos varanumo appo mattum dot product use panna. Sin varanum appadina nee vandu endha edukku poyirnum, cross product ku poyirnum. So inga nama enna prove panna porona, with the usual notation in any triangle ABC, prove by vector method. So in any triangle ABC, prove that A by sin A is equal to B by sin B is equal to C by sin C. So this is we are going to prove. Again we are going to take the same diagram. For the three problems we are drawing the same diagram. Okay, so arrow marks poduradhukku appuram endha pakkam arrow mark podu andha pakkam line extend pannu. Okay, ipo idu vandu A, idu vandu B and this one is C. Appa idu enna angle? Pi minus A. And what is this angle? This is pi minus B. And what is this angle? Pi minus C. Okay. So after writing this, you can write down A vector, B vector and C vector. Now let us start the problem as it is similar. எப்படி நம்ம ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணமோ அதே மாதிரி ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணலாம். இன் ட்ரையாங்கிள் ஏபிசி அப்படின்னு ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிக்கோ. In triangle ABC, AB vector is equal to C vector, BC vector is equal to A vector and CA vector is equal to B vector. இப்ப நமக்கு triangle law of property தெரியும். ஞாபகம் இருக்கா? By triangle law of property என்ன சொல்லலாம் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, half of modulus of A vector cross B vector nu eludalam triangle property padi is equal to half of modulus of b vector cross c vector nu eludalam is equal to half of modulus of c vector cross a vector nu eludalam. So in your book it is start with another method, you can follow this. This will be very easier for you because you have studied what is the triangle property, that is the formula you can use here is 1 by 2 modulus of a cross b, or otherwise it is equal to 1 by 2 modulus of b cross c. So for all the sides you are having 1 by 2, so let us remove 1 by 2 and take the modulus is equal to modulus of b cross c is equal to modulus of c cross a. Okay, so now here we are having modulus. So modulus means we have to use the formula of cross product. Cross product ku formula niyamo iruka ab sin, ipa idu ab cross irundhuchu appa na enna poda porona pi minus c appdinu podanum. ஏனா ஏக்கும் பியும் சேர்ற இடத்துல நமக்கு என்ன ஆங்கிள் கிடைக்கும் பை மைனஸ் சி கிடைக்கும். ஸோ ஏபி சைன் சி சிமிலர்லி அப்போ இங்கே எப்படிப்பா வரும் பிசி சைன் பை மைனஸ் ஏன்னு கிடைக்கும். இங்கே வந்து சிஏ சைன் பை மைனஸ் பின்னு வரும் இல்லையா. ஸோ நாவ் இப்போ இது ஏபி sin 180 minus theta is sin theta. ஆன cos 180 minus theta என்னது minus cos theta. இங்க sin 180 minus theta lies in second quadrant. Second quadrant sin is positive. So sin theta. அப்ப sin c is equal to bc sin a is equal to ca sin b. Okay. இப்ப நமக்கு என்ன ஆன்சர் வரணும் a by sin a b by sin b c by sin c னு வரணும். அப்போ இங்க என்ன பண்ண போறோம்னா டிவைட் பை ஏபிசி பண்ண போறோம். அப்ப இதுல ஏபி ஏபி கேன்சல் ஆயிரும். சோ யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் சைன் சி பை சி. இங்க சைன் ஏ பை ஏன்னு வந்துடும். இங்க டிவைட் பை ஏபிசி பண்ணோம்னா சைன் பி பை பின்னு வந்துடும் இல்லையா. சோ இப்போ ஆனா நமக்கு இன்னமும் ஆன்சர் வரல. வி ஹாவ் டு டேக் த ரெசிப்ரோக்கல் தென் ஒன்லி வி வில் கெட் த ஆன்சர். சோ வாட் இஸ் த ரெசிப்ரோக்கல் ஆஃப் சைன் ஏ பை ஏ? So taking reciprocal, taking reciprocal we will get c by sin c is equal to a by sin a is equal to b by sin b. Hence we prove, hence prove. Is it clear students? So we have completed with cosine formula, projection formula and sine formula to prove all these formula using the vector method. So using vector method means the diagram must be very important, and after drawing the diagram for the three problems also we are using the triangular property, but for the first two we are using a plus b plus c, for the last one we are using the triangle area of triangle formula. Okay. So using that formula we can prove this. Divide by ABC, taking reciprocal, you will get the answer. Okay, so these are all 3 mark questions. So first 2 problems you are having 2 more subdivision, you can try to prove it. In this, this is only 1 subdivision, so it is enough. Now let us go to prove the very important formula, cos of alpha plus beta is equal to cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. It is example 6.3. And sin alpha plus beta is a form example 6.5. So this 2 questions are very important, repeated 5 mark questions. So first let us go with cos. Cos means we have to use the dot product, isn't it? So now example 6.3. Prove by vector method. It is a very important 5 mark questions. Prove by vector method cos of alpha plus beta is equal to cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. Cos alpha plus beta na and the sign change aayirum illaya. Sin of alpha cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. So in the problem ku nama vandu enna panna porona ஒரு டயக்ராம் தான் போட்டு நம்ம ப்ரூவ் பண்ணோம். ஏன்னா எல்லாமே நம்ம செஞ்சிட்டு இருக்கிறது எல்லாமே என்னது ஜியோமெட்ரிக்கல் இன்டர்பிரிட்டேஷன். சரியா? ஸோ இதுக்கு எப்படி டயக்ராம் போட போறோம் அப்படின்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா, ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லெட் அஸ் டிரா எக்ஸ் ஆக்சிஸ் அண்ட் ஒய் ஆக்சிஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் எக்ஸ் ஆக்சிஸ் அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் ஒய் ஆக்சிஸ் அண்ட் திஸ் கேன் பி டேக்கன் அஸ் ஜீரோ. லெட் அஸ் மேக் அன் ஆங்கிள் ஓஏ விச் மேக்ஸ் ஓஏ லைன் மேக்ஸ் அன் ஆங்கிள் ஆல்ஃபா அண்ட் ஓபி லைன் மேக்ஸ் அன் ஆங்கிள் பீட்டா. ஓகே, ஆல்ஃபா பிளஸ் பீட்டானா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் குவாட்ரன்ட்லையும் ஃபோர்த் குவாட்ரன்ட்லையும் டயக்ராம் இருக்கணும். ஸோ இப்போ இது வந்து ஏ. ஸோ ஓஏ மேக்ஸ் அன் ஆங்கிள் ஆல்ஃபா அண்ட் ஓபி மேக்ஸ் அன் ஆங்கிள் பீட்டா. நவ் ட்ரா த பர்பண்டிகுலர் ஃப்ரம் ஏ டு எக்ஸ் ஆக்சஸ் அண்ட் பி டு எக்ஸ் ஆக்சஸ். ஸோ ஏ டு எக்ஸ் ஆக்சஸை வந்து இந்த பர்பண்டிகுலரை நம்ம எம்னு எடுத்துக்கிறோம். அப்போ இந்த பர்பண்டிகுலரை நம்ம எல்னு எடுத்துக்கிறோம். சரியா? So this is the diagram first. Now let us go with the OA vector. Nama OA vector can be taken as A vector and OB vector can be taken as B vector. Seriya, idha first diagram nalla purinjikkom. Alpha plus beta na formula la irundhuchu appadina diagram vandu first quadrant and fourth quadrant la irukano. OA makes an angle alpha with the positive side of x axis. OB makes an angle beta with the positive side of x axis. OA vector is equal to A vector, OB vector is equal to B vector. Draw AL perpendicular to x axis and BM perpendicular, sorry, draw AM and BL perpendicular to x axis. So I am going to write all these points whatever I said now. Let OA vector is equal to A vector. OB vector is equal to B vector. Okay. Now, these two are unit vectors. Okay. First write down. Be the unit vectors. Unit vectors means, what is the meaning for unit vector? Their magnitude value will be equal to 1. Okay. So, modulus of A vector means the value will be equal to 1. Modulus of B vector means the value will be equal to 1. Okay. So, OA vector and OB vector, OA and OB makes an angle alpha and beta which makes an angle alpha and beta respectively. Okay, respectively. Now, with the positive side of x axis, respectively with the positive side of x axis. So always you have to draw the lines on the positive side of x axis. Okay, now we are going to draw AL perpendicular to BM. So AL draw AL BM perpendicular to x axis. Okay, draw AL BM perpendicular to x axis. So now from the diagram we can write OL vector is equal to, what is OL vector from the diagram? Listen to the diagram, students. What is OL vector? OL vector can be taken as OA vector plus AM vector, isn't it? So, OL-ங்கிறது எங்க இருக்கு? நமக்கு x-axis-ல இருக்கு. x-axis-ல இருந்துச்சுனா இது வந்து இந்த ட்ரையாங்கிளுக்கு என்ன சைடு? இது அட்ஜசன் சைடு. அப்போ வாட் இஸ் காஸ் ஆல்ஃபா? காஸ் ஆல்ஃபா இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு அட்ஜசன் சைட் பை, வாட் இஸ் காஸ் ஆல்ஃபா? காஸ் ஆல்ஃபா இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு அட்ஜசன் சைட். வாட் இஸ் அட்ஜசன் சைட்? OL டிவைடட் பை ஹைபோட்டினியூஸ். ஹைபோட்டினியூஸ் இஸ் A வெக்டார், இசன்ட் இட்? So what is OL is equal to? OL is equal to A modulus of A vector cos alpha. So this is nothing but OL. Yena modulus of A vector unit vector nal adu enna vairum? 1 aayirum. So OL is equal to cos alpha varudha. So adha da nam inga elda porom. OL vector is equal to OA vector into cos alpha. OA vector nu eludhikalam. A vector அடுத்து அந்த உள்ள ஃபார்முலாக்குள்ள போறப்ப அதை சப்ஸ்டிட் பண்ணி ஒன் ஆக்கிக்கலாம். ஓகே, ஸோ வி கேன் ரைட் ஹியர் ஓஎல் வெக்டார் இஸ் ஈக்வல் டு மாடுலஸ் ஆஃப் ஏ வெக்டார் இன்டூ cos alpha. Okay. Similarly, we can write down. Now this is equal to again cos alpha. Okay. So OL vector is equal to cos alpha. Similarly, what is LA vector? What is LA vector? LA vector modulus is equal to LA is a opposite side of angle alpha. So opposite side அப்படினா என்ன சொல்லுவோம் sin alpha கண்டுபிடிப்போம் இல்லையா sin alpha is equal to LA divided by modulus of A vector. So what is LA is equal to? LA is equal to modulus of A vector into sin alpha. Correct? So we can substitute here modulus of A vector into sin alpha. The modulus of A vector namak value vandu 1 nu theriyum. So this is equal to sin alpha. Okay. So after finding what is OL vector and LA vector, we can write down what is OL vector. OL vector அப்படிங்கறதை நாம எப்படி எழுதலாம்னா OL vector modulus into I cap. அப்ப OL vector modulus என்னது cos alpha I cap. Similarly, what is LA vector? LA vector எந்த டைரக்ஷன்ல இருக்கு? LA is in the direction of y axis. அப்ப j vector j cap வரணும். அப்ப LA vector into j cap. LA vector modulus into j cap. So what is LA? LA vector is nothing but sin alpha. Sin alpha into, இப்ப j cap ங்கறத பாத்தினா it is with the sign of minus. ஏன் அப்படினோனா minus j cap because it is in the line of y dash, isn't it? So minus. Students, we can take this as this is A and this can be taken as B and here it is beta and here it is alpha. So this is B vector and this is A vector. Okay. So that's the thing we have to change. Now, what is A cap now? What is A cap? We need to find out A cap vector, A vector dot B vector. So what is A cap? It is nothing but OA vector. OA vector can be written as OL vector plus LA vector. What is OL vector? OL vector is equal to cos alpha I cap minus sin alpha j cap. Okay, take this as equation number 1. And then similarly you have to find out B cap. Similarly, B cap is equal to cos beta. In the place of alpha, we have to write beta. Cos beta I cap plus sin beta j cap. Why we are writing plus? Because it is in the first quadrant. Here it is LA is in the fourth quadrant. We are mentioning as minus. Here it is in the first quadrant beta. So we are having a plus. Okay. So now we can find out the dot product of A vector dot B vector. A vector dot B vector is equal to modulus of A vector, modulus of B vector, cos, what's the angle between A and B? Alpha plus beta. Okay. So this is, we can write it as modulus of A vector is nothing but 1 and modulus of B vector is nothing but 1 because they two are unit vectors. So the answer will be cos alpha plus beta. Take this as equation number 1. So using the definition we have written this, and now using the value of the dot product, what is A vector dot B vector? It is, we have to write down the values, that is cos alpha I cap minus sin alpha j cap dot cos beta I cap minus cos, sorry, plus cos beta sin beta j cap. Sin beta j cap. Okay. Now when you are multiplying this, taking the dot product of this, what you will get? Cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. Okay. So take this as equation number 2. So from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2. What is proved? The both left hand side are equal. So we can equate the right hand side, that is cos alpha plus beta is equal to cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. Okay, so we have proved the formula of cos alpha plus beta using the vector product. So first, so prove by vector method, cos of alpha plus beta, cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. Always take beta in the first quadrant and alpha in the fourth quadrant. So alpha here, A will be here and B will be there. So we can write what is LA and what is OL. OL is nothing but the line which is the adjacent side for angle alpha. And LA is the line which is the opposite side for angle alpha. So we can easily find out what is cos alpha and what is sin alpha. Okay. So we can find out what is cos alpha and what is sin alpha. Sin alpha is nothing but LA, because it is the opposite side, LA by hypotenuse. So we can use the diagram and write down what is cos alpha and sin alpha, and we can substitute in this place. Now we are going to see the next one, next formula, that is using sine. In the exercise, we are having cos alpha minus beta. So for cos alpha minus beta, you can take both the lines on the first quadrant. Okay. So this is the first, we can take this as A and this is B. Totally the angle here is alpha and here the angle is beta. So the angle between A and B is alpha minus beta. So to take the problem of cos alpha minus beta in the exercise, you can use this diagram. Both the lines are will be in the first quadrant. But for cos alpha plus beta, one line will be in the first quadrant and the another line will be in the fourth quadrant. Then only we can take the angle as alpha plus beta. Okay. So do it as homework. I am going to do the next example 6.5. prove by vector method sine of alpha minus beta is equal to sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta. So this is the next thing we are going to prove by vector method. Sine of alpha minus beta is equal to sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. Again the same method we are going to follow. Let us make the x axis and y axis. Now just now I said that for alpha minus beta, you have to take both the lines on the first quadrant. So let us make a line A, makes an angle alpha. So let us consider this to be A. So this is A vector. And this one as another line, let us take it as B. This is OB, B vector, and makes an angle beta. Okay. So draw AL perpendicular to X axis and BM perpendicular to Y axis. So all the things are same, only the diagram is different. So we will get the angle between A and B here is alpha minus beta. So let us start. Let OA vector is equal to A vector, OB vector is equal to B vector. Okay. are the unit vectors. Mention the word, it is unit vectors. So only you can apply the magnitude value as 1, okay, which makes an angle, which makes an angle alpha and beta respectively on the positive side of x-axis, always on the positive side of x-axis. Okay, so these are the things first we have to write down. Okay, now let us go with what is a cap and what is b cap. Already we have seen in the previous problem, so we can straight away write down what is a cap. A cap is equal to cos alpha I cap plus sin alpha j cap. Okay, similarly what is b cap? B cap is equal to cos beta I cap plus sin beta j cap. Both are plus because both the lines are in the first quadrant. In the previous one, beta will be positive and alpha will be negative. Okay, so be clear that here both are plus symbol. Okay, now let us go with angle between a vector and b vector. Here is angle between a vector and b vector is alpha minus beta. Okay, and then we can write down here it is a sign. Sign means we have to go with the cross product, isn't it? So what is the cross product? B vector cross a vector, take it as b cross a, then only we will get both the answers are similar. So b cross a is nothing but modulus of b vector, modulus of a vector, sine alpha minus beta. And what vector is perpendicular to both a vector and b vector? That is k cap. Okay, so here what is b vector? Modulus of b vector is 1 and modulus of a vector is 1. So we are getting the answer as sine alpha minus beta into k cap. So this is by using the definition of b vector cross a vector. Now we are going to use the value, find the value for b cross a. So how to find out the value for b cross a? The value for b cross a can be find out using the determinant. Okay, so now we can write what is b vector. B vector is nothing but cos beta, cos beta sin beta, there is no k component, so 0. Next one is cos alpha sin alpha, no k component, therefore it is equal to 0. Okay, so now when you are taking I, 0 minus 0, j, that is 0 minus 0, so only with k we can take the terms. So k cap into what it is, sin alpha cos beta, sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. Listen carefully students, we have taken b cap. We are taken b cross a, why? Because if you are taking a cross b, it will become as cos alpha sin alpha as the first row and cos beta sin beta as the second row. So the sign will be not correct here, it will change us. So we have to take it as b cross a in the left hand side of both the equation, then only we will get sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So let us take this as equation number 2. So now from equation 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, both the LHS are equal, so we can equate the RHS. So it is sin alpha minus beta into k cap is equal to k cap into sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So now here you can listen to this, that is the, both the sides we are having k cap, so removing k cap we will get the formula of sin alpha minus beta. Sin alpha minus beta is equal to sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So we have hence proved the formula sin alpha minus beta. In exercise you are having sin alpha plus beta. So try to prove the exercise problem of cos alpha minus beta and sin alpha plus beta. Thank you, students.